In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most dearest fault. Therefore, I ask the Most Mary Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
O God, who in your providence raised up Pope St. Pius V in your church, that the faith might be safeguarded, the more fitting worship be offered to you, grant through his intercession we may participate in your mystery, with lively faith and fruitful charity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, "Get up and head south on the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza, the desert route." So he got up and set out. There was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, that is the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury, who had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go and join up with that chariot." Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. Like a sheep he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who will tell of his posterity? For his life is taken from the earth. Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, "I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with this scripture passage, he proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water. And the eunuch said, "Look, there is water. What is to prevent my being baptized?" Then he ordered the chariot to stop, and Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. When they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued on his way rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus and went about proclaiming the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Bless our God, you peoples, loudly sound his praise. He has given life to our souls and has not let our feet slip.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Hear now, all you who fear God, while I declare what he has done for me. When I appeal to him in words, praise was on the tip of my tongue. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Blessed be God who refused me not, my prayer or his kindness. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, "No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him. I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, they shall all be taught by God. Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord. Philip now becomes truly the evangelist, proclaiming the kingdom of God, proclaiming Jesus Christ crucified and risen from the dead. And we have this Ethiopian eunuch, a rather strange figure in Scripture, that St. Luke would choose him as an example of conversion. He's reading the prophet Isaiah, but he doesn't understand the suffering servant. So Philip explains it to him, that it must be this way. He then asks for baptism. Philip then is snatched up by the Spirit, we are told, to go wherever the Spirit wishes him to go. That's the work of an evangelist, the work of missionaries in the church, always in and through the church. Today's gospel, our Lord continues with the bread of life. This time he becomes more specific. The people didn't quite understand him. He says, "I am the bread of life," and he repeats that, and then finally concludes by saying, "And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." Now it's becoming more specific and more dangerous in a sense. He's really giving himself completely, not just in some symbolic way, but in a very real way, his own flesh and blood, which we celebrate every time we celebrate Mass. We celebrate the suffering servant from Isaiah, crucified and risen from the dead, who becomes present in the glory and victory of his body and blood. Today we celebrate the memorial of St. Pius V, born in 1504, became a Dominican, became Pope in 1566, presided over the actual bringing about the proclamations of the Council of Trent. He gave us the Roman Catechism, the Roman Missal, the Roman Breviary. The Roman Missal, today we call the Extraordinary Form. A great man and a great teacher who lived through very difficult times, including the Battle of Lepanto. He's an example to us of fidelity in the midst of very difficult times, and even in the midst of the church being persecuted throughout much of Europe. He died in 1572. Let us pray. For Jean Retz, through whom this Mass is being offered, for the souls of all the faithful departed, especially our relatives, friends, and benefactors, for all who have died in the battlefield, all victims of violence, terrorism, natural disaster. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed. For the church throughout the world, her members will always remain faithful to what they have received. We pray to the Lord. For all nations of the world, especially our own, that they may come to know Jesus Christ crucified and risen from the dead, and know him in the Eucharist, we pray to the Lord. For all those who are sick and suffering and dying, that in their suffering they may know that they are united to the suffering servant in his suffering and in his victory. For those who are greatly tempted, for those who have rejected faith or lost it, we pray to the Lord. For greater respect for human life, we pray to the Lord. For an increase in vocations to priesthood and the consecrated life, those young men and women will be visible signs of the Lord's victory, visible signs of his suffering love, for a greater reverence for that love made present in marriage and a single life, we pray to the Lord. For our bishop, priests, deacons, and seminarians, and for the American hierarchy, having spent time in the presence of the bread of life, they may then be visible signs of what they have seen and heard. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. For all those suffering from this virus, they may be healed. For an end to this virus, and we may be preserved and protected from it. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of us here, that our lives will be a true witness to what God has done for us, particularly what he has done for us in his body and blood, in his Eucharistic presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. We now join our prayers to those of the Mother of the Eucharist as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. pure goodness we have received the bread of the altar. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us a bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. With your goodness we have received the wine of your fruit of the vine and work of human hands. Become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept us with your hands for the praise of the Lord God's name, for our good and for all who will do
it. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice and made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, you may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift up our voices.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover hath been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment, the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your faith. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Sanctus,
Sanctus
Dominus Deo Salvo, Venis cum Caeli et Terra, Gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, Benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all things. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord.
He took that and gave me thanks for it. Gave it to me for my birthday.
Take this. Thank you. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence, ministering to you. Humbly we pray that by taking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. And with Francis, our Pope, and Luis Raphael, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the and all who have died in their mercy, welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostle, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is forever and ever.
Amen. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, and peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
On your stead, we call this day.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to enter into your presence, but say a word. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord. And lead those you have imbued with heavenly mystery to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For a swift, just, and lasting peace, the safety and well-being of the men and women in our armed forces, especially those from our own parish and diocese. Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled for thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession, but loved and aided, inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my mother. To thee do I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petition, but in thy mercy, hear my answer.
The Church in our country, the Church in our diocese, our bishop, for our nation, when entered this virus, and for our protection and preservation, St. Michael,
our archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke and we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, pass into the hell Satan, and all the evil spirits that prowl about the world, seeking the good of souls.
Mary, Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
St. Joseph, patron of the universal Church, Pius V,
pray for us.
The 14 holy helpers,
pray for us.
Mother Seton,
pray for us.
St. John Vianney.